Hello students, this is Nilanjana Sanyal from My Math Friend Online and eParashana. Yet another session on simultaneous linear equations. And today we will be solving simultaneous linear equations by the comparison method. We will be learning about the comparison method today. Okay, so first of all, let us take up a sum. We have a sum over here. We have two linear equations, 12x plus 85y equal to minus 49, and the second one is 19x minus 34y equal to 91. So we have been given two linear equations involving the same two variables x and y, and we have to find the values of x and y so that they simultaneously satisfy both the two given equations. Okay? So let us go through the steps one by one. Step number one, we number the two given equations as equation one and equation two. So first of all, let us number these two equations. This is equation one, and this one becomes our equation number two. Okay. Now coming to the step number two. We find the value of one of the two variables in terms of the other variable from both the equations. This is important, from both the equations, and number them as equations 3 and 4, equation number 3 and 4. Do you remember we had done the same thing for the substitution method? We had expressed the variable x in terms of y, or we had expressed the variable y in terms of the variable x. But in the substitution method, we had done that for only a single equation. We had taken only equation 1 or we had taken equation 2. But for the comparison method, we will be expressing, we will be first of all selecting one of the two variables, and we will be expressing that variable in terms of the other variable from both the equations. Okay, so that we get two expressions for that variable, and we number those two equations as number 3 and number 4. So let us do that. We can express the value of x in terms of y, or we can express the value of y in terms of x. Let us choose x and let us express the value of x in terms of the variable y. Okay. Now, coming to the first equation. Let us take up the first equation. Let us write the first equation again. It is 12x plus 85y equal to minus 49. Next, we will be expressing this value of x in terms of y. So what should we do? We have to take this term containing y to this side by the transposition method. And if we take this term containing y, that is 85y, it is a positive term, it is a plus 85y. When we take this term to the right hand side of the equal to sign, the sign will get changed and it will become a minus 85y, negative 85y. Or else what can we do? We can add a negative 85y to both sides of the equal to sign. Let us do that. So we have 12x plus 85y minus 85y equal to minus 49 and minus 85y. So that these two terms will get cancelled. Next, we have this 12x on the left hand side of the equal to sign, and on the right hand side we are having two terms. One is minus 49 and the other is minus 85y. Okay. So next we have to find the value of x. Now we are having a 12x. So in order to have the value of x with a coefficient of 1, what do? We divide both the sides of the equal to sign by the number 12. So we do that. -49 - 85y. This gives us the value of x as these two will get cancelled, and we have x equal to, sorry, this will be divided by 12. So this is x equal to -49 - 85y divided by 12. Okay, so this becomes our equation number 3. We have expressed the value of the variable x in terms of the other variable, that is in our case y. Okay, again I am repeating, we could have expressed the value of y in terms of x. But we have to select one variable and we have to express that variable in terms of the other variable for both the two equations. So since we have selected the variable x, we have to express the value of x in terms of y from equation number 2 as well. So let us write the equation number 2 over here. It is a 19x. -34y equal to 91. Now we have to find the value of x in terms of y. So we have to take this term containing y to this side. So let us do it by the transposition method. So we have a 19x. And when we change the side of this term, when we take this term to the right-hand side of the equal to sign, the sign will get changed, the associated sign will get changed. It is a negative over here. It will be changed to a positive sign. So we have 91 + 34y. Okay. Now, in order to get the value of x, simple x with a coefficient of 1, we divide both sides by 19. This is 19x divided by 19 is equal to 91 + 34y whole divided by 19. And these two will get cancelled and we will be having x is equal to 91 + 34y divided by 19. This becomes our equation number 4. We have expressed the value of this variable x in terms of y from equation 1 as well as from equation 2 and numbered these two equations as equation 3 and equation 4. Okay. Next comes the step number 3. Step number 3 says that we equate the right hand sides of equations 3 and 4 since their left hand sides are the same. You see the equation 3 and equation 4, the left hand side of the equation 3 is x containing a simple x, as well as the equation 4 is containing a simple x in the left hand side of the equal to sign. So the left hand side of both the two equations are the same. Therefore, their right hand sides will also be the same. So we equate the right hand sides of equations 3 and 4 since their left hand sides are the same to get the numeric value of the other variable, which in our case is y, okay? Because the right-hand sides of both the equations contain the y term, the y variable. So, next what do? We equate the right-hand sides. So, we write -49 - 85y whole divided by 12 equal to 91 plus 34 y whole divided by 19. So both are fractions. Remember, in the substitution method, I had said that if ever you have a situation where you are having a coefficient of 1 for any variable in any of the two given equations, go for that variable. But over here in these two equations, we do not have any term containing a coefficient of 1. So we have to deal with fractions. We do not have any other alternative. Okay. So we have framed this equation. Next, what do we do? We will be doing the cross multiplication. So this becomes, we will be multiplying this whole thing by 19. So this is, let me put a bracket, minus 49 minus 85y multiplied by 19 equal to 91 plus 34y whole multiplied by 12. Okay, so this is a binomial, this is a monomial, this is a constant term, again this is a binomial and this is a constant number. So these two are numbers. So we know the multiplication process. We will be multiplying both the terms of the binomial with this number 19. And I have done the multiplication before in advance so that I can write the product straight away, just to minimize the time of recording, time of the video. But you have to perform the multiplication. You have to do the actual multiplication to get the result, to get the products. So I am writing the products right away. Minus 49 terms times 19 will be giving us a minus 931. And minus 85 times 19 will be giving us a minus 1615. So it is minus 1615y equal to 91 times 12 is 1092 plus 34 times 12 is 408. It is 408y. We have got a linear equation now, and we have to solve for the variable y. We have to find the value of the variable y. So we will be getting all the terms containing the y in the left hand side of the equal to sign, and we will be taking all the constant terms to the right hand side of the equal to sign. So let us do that. Let us keep this term in the left hand side, and so we write 1615y, and we are taking the help of the transposition method right now. So we are taking this term 408y, or rather plus 408y, to the left hand side of the equal to sign, so that it will be a negative 408y. So it becomes minus 408y equal to, now this is the constant term that is already present on the right hand side of the equal to sign. And now 408y was initially on the right hand side. We have changed it and changed its place, and we have taken this 408 to the left hand side of the equal to sign. Now initially minus 931 was on the left hand side of the equal to sign. We are taking it to the right hand side of the equal to sign, so the associated sign will get changed. The minus will be changed to a plus, so it will become a positive 931. So it is a positive 931 plus 931. Okay. Next, we have to add the like terms. We are having two like terms and both are having the same sign. So we'll be adding these two numbers and we will be affixing the common sign in front. So let us write this minus first of all. And 1615 plus 408. If we add these two, we will be getting a 2023. We have a 2023y. So it is a negative 2023y equal to, now we will be adding these two, 1092 plus 931. When we add these two, we will be getting a positive 2023. I have done all these additions and multiplications in advance. I know the results beforehand, but, so I'm just directly writing the results, but you have to compute them. Just to minimize the time of the video, I have computed these things before. So we have to find the value of y. So it becomes, on dividing both sides by minus 2023, we have 2023 divided by minus 2023. So these two will get cancelled and the sign over here doesn't cancel. These two signs will get cancelled and we will be having the result as y equal to minus 1 because of this sign over here. Okay. So we are having the numeric value of y as y equal to minus 1. We have got the value of y. Now we have to find the value of x. How do we find that? Let us go back to the steps. Step number 4 says, we put this numeric value of the other variable, that is y equal to minus 1, in either equation 3 or in equation 4. To get the value of the first variable, that is x in our case. So we can put the value of this variable y in equation 3 to get the value of the variable x, or we can put the value of this variable y in equation 4 to get the value of the variable x. Let us take up equation 3. Okay, so again let us draw this line and let us take up equation number 3. Let us write this equation number 3 first of all. X equal to minus 49 minus 85y divided by 12 is the equation number 3. Now we will be putting the value of y in this equation. So we have x equal to minus 49 and minus 85 multiplied by a negative 1 divided by 12. Okay. So we have, this implies x equal to minus 49 and negative when multiplied together will be giving us a positive result. So it will be a plus 85 divided by 12, which in turn implies x equal to, now 85 minus 49 will be giving us a 36. 36 divided by 12, which in turn implies that x equal to 3, because 12 times 3 is obviously 36. We know the 3 is multiplication table. So x equal to 3, we have got the value of x, numerical value of x as 3 and the numerical value of y as y equal to minus 1. So let us write the answer. X equal to 3 and y equal to minus 1. This is the answer. Okay? This is the answer. Now let us do the checking part. Let us perform the checking part. Let us see whether our answer is correct or not. How do we perform the checking? We will be putting the values of the two variables x and y in the two given equations, and we will be seeing whether the two equations get satisfied by these values, these two values or not. So 12x, the first equation is 12x plus 85y equal to minus 49. So let us write this first equation. It is 12x plus 85y equal to minus 49. This is our first equation. Putting the value of the variables x and y, what do we get? 12 times 3 plus 85 times minus 1 equal to minus 49. This is equal to 12 times 3 is 36, and 85 times minus 1 is minus 85. Okay? Equal to minus 49. No. We are having two numbers with two different signs. This is a plus 36 and this is a minus 85. So what do? We have to perform a subtraction. We perform a subtraction. We do subtract 36 from the greater number, the larger number, that is 85. And since this bigger number is having a minus sign attached to it, we will be putting this sign in the result. So it will be a negative result, and its value will be equal to 85 minus 35. What is that equal to? 85 minus 35 is 50, right? So now we are having one more. It is 36. So the result will be one less, that is minus 49. So we are having a minus 49 on both the sides of the equal to sign. So the values of x as 3 and y as minus 1 satisfy this first equation, 12x plus 85y equal to minus 49. Let us take up the second equation. The second equation is 19x minus 34y equal to 91. Okay, 19x minus 34y. Let us write it. 19x minus 34y equal to 91. This is our second equation. Now again, we will be putting the values of x and y in this equation, and we have 19 times 3 minus 34 times minus 1 equal to 91. And what is 19 times 3? It is a 57. So it is a 57, and 34 times minus 1 is obviously minus 34, which when multiplied by this minus sign will be giving us a plus 34. Equal to 91. And when we add these two numbers, 57 and 34, we see that the result is a plus 31. So, plus 91. So we see that on both the sides of the equal to sign, we are having the same number, and that is equal to 91. So the values of x as 3 and y as minus 1 satisfy the second equation as well. So x equal to 3 and y equal to minus 1 simultaneously satisfy both the two given equations. Hence, we have obtained the right result. Okay, so once more, a quick recapitulation of this method, comparison method, what we do. First of all, we number these two equations, given equations as number 1 and number 2. Step number 2 is we find the value of one of the two variables in terms of the other variable from both the equations and number the two equations as 3 and 4 that we have done. We have taken x and we could have taken y also. But over here we have taken x and we have expressed the value of x in terms of y. We have taken, this is the first equation, and we have obtained equation number 3, that is x in terms of y from equation 1. And numbered it as equation number 3. Again, we have taken up the second equation and expressed the value of x in terms of y from the second equation and numbered it as equation number 4. Next, since both the sides are having of the equations 3 and 4 are having the same value, that is x equal to, therefore we can equate the right hand sides. They will also be equal, obviously, to get the numerical value of the other variable, which in our case is y. So we have done that exactly. We have done the same thing. We have computed, we have equated this part to get the value of y, and we have obtained the value of y as y equal to minus 1. And finally, what do? We put this numeric value of the other variable in either equation 3 or in equation 4 to get the value of the first variable, which in our case is x. So we could have taken equation 4 also, but we have taken equation 3, and this is the equation 3, and we have put the value of y as minus 1 in this expression or equation, and we have got the value of x as x equal to 3. And we have done the checking and we have seen that x equal to 3 and y equal to minus 1 simultaneously satisfy both the two given equations. Okay, so this brings us to the end of the comparison method. Thank you for hearing.